Today I'm sharing all of my favorite Halloween DIYs. Keep watching. I'm Brandy and this is Making It My Own DIYs.
We're going to start off with some of these little pipe cleaners. I got black. And then I've got a variety of
raffia in different colors. I've got some metallic mesh. You can use whatever color you like, but this is 10 inch mesh. I'm only going to need part of one roll. I have a roll of mesh ribbon that is black and a variety of thrifted and Dollar Tree ribbons. And then I have three of these gorgeous Dollar Tree yard stakes. The skeleton, the cat, and the pumpkin, and they all have little hats on. So these came from obviously the Halloween section. You can see the information here. And then I'm going to take a 3 foot long yard stick to make our swag. We're going to start by removing the tags and the stakes from each one of these. If you can save your stakes, you can use those for other projects. I managed to save two and broke the end off of the last one. But I can still use it for other things. Just broke that off of there. Be careful, they do have little little staples in the back side of the stake, so just be careful not to hurt yourself. Okay, so I'm gonna go down this just like I've done in another video. You're gonna go about an inch down and take your pipe cleaners and twist off to the side. We're gonna put another one to twist off to the other side. I've done this before and I will try to leave a link to the lady whose video I watch where I learned how to make these. And you can go check her channel out. She does really, really cute stuff. So we're gonna go all the way down here in 15 sections. Two, then one, then two, then one, all the way down to the end. And we're gonna cut our mesh. I'm using a rotary cutter and a mat, but you can use scissors if you want to. I've just found this is a little bit easier to do. And I'm going to be using, I think I use 12 inch sections of this, maybe 10 or 12, something like that. And I'm going to make a whole bunch of these. I will try to count them and give you the information in the description box, but you just want to be sure that you have enough for all of your little wires there. All right, we're gonna have to have something to secure these onto our swag. So I'm using these pipe cleaners, some hot glue, and little scraps of paper that I've already got cut down. I like to use scraps from like the backing of stickers and things like that that come from Dollar Tree, and just cut those into strips and you can use them again. And we're gonna do that to each one of these. And then set them aside to let them cool because you don't want to be twisting those around while the glue is still wet because they'll just pop right off. So while those are drying, we're going to start with our cruffles. What you're going to do is take your mesh, you're going to roll over two or three times and then take your fingers and do like your little tickling motion. Walk your fingers down that mesh, flip it around, twist the other side two or three times and pinch it in the middle. So you almost have like a little bow tie, but that neatly tucks in all of your loose frays in the inside. You're gonna do the same thing with each one of those. If you've got a bunch of clips and you wanna do this all before you start attaching them, you can certainly do that, but my experience with this mesh is that it will attach and crawl onto everything you have in your craft space. So if you don't want a big mess, it might be easier for you to do one bundle at a time. So on every section that you see here that goes off to the sides, we're going to do two. So there'll be two on this side, there'll be two on the other side. And then in the middle, there will be two in the middle. We're just making a little X and then attaching those down, if that makes sense. Just showing you here again, a little bit slower so you can see. Make an X, put your X down in the center of your pipe cleaner and then give that a few twists to hold that in place. All right, after you have that done, we are going to start cutting down our little pieces of ribbon, and we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. We're going to have 9 pieces cut for each one. We're going to do longer pieces for this because it's going to be folded over. So you want to be sure that these are longer, and I think I've got about 16 inches for those. We're going to make almost like we would lay out a messy bow. We're going to take one of each piece of these ribbons like this. And then on top, we're going to let that loop over like it already wants to do, about an inch and a half or 2 inches. Place that on top in a loop. And then you're just going to start walking your fingers toward the center, just like that. And so the little top section looks like a bow. It's coming out there, but you can see you just tuck it back in there. You can use, if you can't hold this all in your hand, it's totally okay to go ahead and use twist ties or something like that on it to hold it before you put it down. Excuse my head, I stood up to do this so I can make sure that you can see what I'm doing. So I was underneath my viewfinder. I try to stay out of the way, but every now and then I do get kind of in the way. So I do apologize for that. And it was a bad hair day. It was a very bad hair day. I think it's fitting that it's in a Halloween video and it looks like I'm wearing a disastrous wig. Okay, so continuing along, we're going to do the same thing. Pinch it in the middle, press that down, pinch it up in the middle. And then we're going to place that down. Just make sure that you're not untwisting your pipe cleaner that's there on the bottom. Make sure that if you've gotten in the habit of going clockwise, continue to go clockwise. Or whichever way, so that you don't untwist your items. I hope that made sense. I think I need more coffee. Okay, so continuing along, we're going to skip the middle sections. We're only going to do the sections that lay to the side. The reason we're doing that is because, well, it would be a waste of ribbon. Because we're going to have our little Halloween faces on each of those little blank spots. So all you would be doing is covering it up if you did put it in the middle. So we're just going to leave it off. Save our ribbon for some other projects. Continuing along all the way down. Now you could always dovetail your pieces before you start if you want, but you certainly don't have to, because I ended up doing it later anyway. Okay, there we go. Twisty twisty. And then the last section on the bottom is a single section, but I'm going to put it on the bottom anyway. So that's the only little middle section that's going to get a bow. Begin to fluff. We all know how to fluff, especially if you've been watching my videos. I'm crazy about the bow fluffing. Fluffing simply means pulling your sections apart so you can see each one of your little colors. See, I undid my bow. Not a big deal. Just twist it back on. Fluff them out. Pick them up. Lift them. Twist them. Whatever you need to do so that you can get all the pretty sides facing forward. And then, yes, it would have been easier to dovetail this in the beginning, but, you know, sometimes you get started on a project and you're not exactly sure. But I ended up liking this, so I went ahead and went with it. And then I'll spare you. You don't want to watch me dovetail this entire thing, but, you know, just so you get an idea, that's what you do. And we're going to go all the way down, fixing it up. Now, in the little bald spot where you have no ribbon, that's where we're going to twist our little black ties around and attach the sign to that swag that is underneath it. You can kind of play with your ribbon, play with your cruffles, fix them so that they are displayed in whatever way that you find pleasing. And then we're going to continue around. If you have any pieces of wires that are still showing, tuck them into the insides or clip them off, whichever way you choose. And then continue on until you get every one of your little signs fastened down. Oh, this cat is the cutest one, I think. It is so cute. Okay, so now I'm just arranging the faces, and I'm kind of, you know, one goes one way, one goes the other way. Just trying to get it. Yep, looks good to me. So then we're going to turn it over, and then go ahead and attach those down where they're not going to come loose. You want to make sure that they're all about the same depth in there so they don't fall off. Now, this is not going to be on a glass door. If it was, then you would want to spray paint your your yardstick black, you know, something that would be more appealing to look at, but I'm not going to be looking at mine, and I did not glue down my ties. That way I could do another project with this same long yardstick if I choose. I have some more of this table scatter left over, and it is orange and black. I think it looks good with what I have going on here. It is glittery. It came from the Dollar Tree. I'm just going to, first of all, cut down some of these pieces and cover up the little holes where the hangers were on these stakes. That's where the price tags were. I really don't know any other reason you would want it there. I guess it was just for the store to show them, maybe. I don't know. But I can't think of a good reason why a stake would have a hole in the top. Anyway, moving along. You can use any ornaments you want to, or you don't have to use ornaments at all. But to embellish, I thought ornaments would be really cute. And these are the ones that you can get, of course, at Dollar Tree. And they come in these little tubes, and you can get a variety of different ones, depending on what stakes that you choose. Whatever will match what you have going on in yours. So I've just chosen black and orange for mine. We got a little bit of glitter in the signs. I'm not a big glitter person, but I think at holiday time, especially like Halloween and maybe some at Christmas, I think it's whimsical. You know, it's fun. Those are holidays that are supposed to be fun. I'm not into anything that is scary and that would, you know, gross you out, I guess. I don't know if people even use the term gross you out anymore. I'm 48 years old, so that is something that I still say. I just like the stuff that's cute. And I have young kids in my house, and I don't want to scare them to death. Okay, so if you remember my last video, I did the little cauldron. We made the fire underneath. Well, it gave me an idea that it would make also something really cute to put on this sign. So I'm going to just put this around my hand, three colors here. I'm going to do it all at one time. And I wrapped them around about 10 times. And then once I get to the end, I'm just going to trim it off. And I'm going to tie it up the same way as I did before. Just making sure that my loose ends are definitely in there. Use whatever colors are going to coordinate with what you have going on. So I'm just going to tie that in a double knot so it doesn't come out. Going to pull that down, hold on to the knot where I tied it, and just cut that straight through the bottom, almost like you're making a tassel. And I thought, you know what? This is so cute. It kind of looks like straw, and it just reminds me of like a carnival or like a haunted hayride or something like that, you know, that you would maybe go to in autumn. And it looks rustic to me. It looks really cute, I think. What do you think? Okay, so now we can choose one of the signs if you want to. You don't have to, but I've chosen one that was already on one of the picks we had. I mean, why not use it? It's right there. Going to use a good bit of glue and this dowel because I had it there. And then I'm going to put some glue on the back to attach that together and a little bit of paper that I've just went ahead and bent over. And protect your hands because it's super hot. And then we're just going to attach this to the back of that sign. Attach that down. It'll stay still for you. And this is kind of what you got. I'm going to flip it over and use just a piece of wire here attached to that frame, and that's going to be your hanger. Do you like this? I really like this. I think it turned out better than I thought it would. You can certainly make this thicker, wider if you would like. You can use a thicker mesh besides the 10 inch, maybe use something bigger than that, but I think this works really good for what I needed. It's, I think, a good inspiration piece for you to play off of, whatever it is that you like, whatever theme that you like. Dollar Tree has lots of really cute picks, and from what I'm seeing, you can also get a lot of good stuff from Dollar General. So just see what you have, see what you like to use, and go for it. I love vintage Halloween. I've been doing it for a few years now, and I really love it. I think it's fun. Okay, now for the next project. This is the vintage Halloween mini garland. We're going to use some thin black ribbon, some ornaments from Dollar Tree, and the rest of my little pieces here. I did leave out the witch because her colors did not match what I had going on, so she's to the side for another project. You're going to cut a couple of pieces of jute to make some little loops to go on the back of each one of these pieces, and that's going to be like a little hanger. You don't have to do this if you don't want to use a hanger, because I do later end up having to glue it down to make it stay in place. But it works. It works until I get everything where it needs to be. All right, so I'm going to start off with a little black glittery ornament. Then I'm going to add the cat, and then an orange ornament, and then another one. And you can see I've got a pattern. Got a little pattern going here. Then when I know about how long I want it to be, I'm going to tie a knot over that black ornament in the bottom. Now we're going to make some little tassels. I'm going to make three loops in this. Same thing as you've already seen me do on the other stuff. It's old news by now. You are a professional at making these things. This is going to be a little bit of a variation. You make it the same way, but it's going to be tied down, and then we're going to make the tassel out of it. So I just put it all together, trimmed it up to make sure that it was nice and even on the bottom. Now I'm just going to tie it onto that piece of string. Tie one of those between each one of the ornaments. Then I'm going to take another piece of the raffia, go down about a half an inch to an inch, and then tie a knot right there. And there we have a little tassel. You can take a little dot of hot glue and press that down and make that little tie become part of your tassel. And you can see here, that's what I've done here. Otherwise, it wants to fluff out. Tie that on. And this is going to be a cute little short garland that you could use on your coffee bar. You could use this on a tiered tray. You could use this on maybe even like your vanity mirror or bathroom mirror, maybe in a kid's room, on the maybe a dresser mirror or something like that. It's just a little garland for a small place that I think has a big impact. It's very festive looking. Now I'm just trying to make sure that my tassels are about the same size. And then once I get them where I want them to be, and I know how much spacing I need, I'll go ahead and glue them down. And so that's what you see me doing there. I'm just gluing down the ornaments, the garland, and the little cloth pieces. Just like that. It's very inexpensive and pretty easy to make. I would love for you to subscribe to my channel if you are not already subscribed. Our family is growing.
Alright, so the first one is going to require a little wooden block or breadboard and some stickers from Dollar Tree. You're also going to need some paint and some paper, stuff like that. This is what we're going to start with. I'm going to start by taking off the tag on the back. Be sure you take all that stuff off. And then I'm going to use kind of a coarse grit sanding paper to get around the edges. I got this little breadboard at Goodwill, and it had very rough edges, kind of splintery, so I wanted to clean all that off, and then of course afterwards wipe all the dust away so it doesn't interfere with the rest of your products sticking down, like your paint and your glue and stuff like that. Okay, so now I'm going to choose a sticker. I want this to go on a little coffee bar section in my house, so I chose these stickers because I thought they would be really cute. Now this is just a little paper pad that originally comes from Target, and I got it at Dirt Cheap. I'm going to mix two paints to try to get the right color here, so I'm going to take an orange and try to match that pumpkin as close as possible. I didn't quite get it, I'll just, you know, spoiler alert, but it's close enough. So I'm just mixing it up with a little wood stick in my cup here. And I'm just going to start laying this on just to the top of this block. I don't completely coat the sides, but you can go ahead and do that if you want to. I'm going to be sanding a little bit more shortly, and I wanted to make sure that I didn't take too much paint away. All right, so we're going to trace out how much paper we need to cover up a portion of the bottom, and we're going to put it on with a glue stick. This used to be purple, but I've had it for some time now. Bought it on clearance a long time ago, and the purple has faded, but the adhesiveness is still good. It still works perfectly. So this is not a perfect fit, and that is not a problem. I'm going to press from the inside outward, just like I always do. And you can see how it overhangs the edges here. And I'm just going to take my sanding block and just sand down and away. And this is going to take the edge off, the excess off, give you a nice clean finish, just like that. Now you can go back over with your paint and finish up any part that you want to finish. I didn't quite mix up enough, but I used what I had. All right, so I love this one because I know when I get up in the mornings, I want my coffee before anything else. And he looks so tired. So we're gonna put him down here. I'm just trying to find a spot that I think looks good. And I know I wanna use a couple of these stickers. So I'm going to put the little cup on here and press it down once I know that that's where I want them to be. And then I'm going to take the little bat sticker. Couple of options of where it could go, but I think the top's going to be cute. And then I'm going to embellish it with a little bit of my jute cord and wrap it around back. I'm going to start my glue on the back side so it's nice and clean in the front. A little bit of hot glue, press that down in there. And then just wind it around the board. It's going to overlap the paint and the paper area there. Just like that. No rhyme or reason. You can use any type of trim that you want to use, or you don't have to use anything at all. You could use a pretty ribbon or colored cords, anything like that if you'd like. So this is a little bow I had made earlier. I showed my mother how to make a bow. We were working on our bows. So I already had it and I'm going to use it right over here on the side. Now this is pressed down, and I'm going to take that same sandpaper and just go back over and take the edge off so you can see the wood underneath. It's just going to give it the rustic look that I enjoy in my home, but you certainly can leave this part out if you would like. There you go. I'm into the cutesy Halloween stuff. How about you? On to number four, little chubby pumpkin. I'm going to take my white chalk paint and give this a good coat, laying it on kind of thick. And when you do that, you're going to have to give it extra dry time. Although chalk paint does dry pretty quickly. I always put my things in front of a fan that I have in the room in my craft space. Once it is dry, I'm using my glue stick. See, I'm trying to give you options between the Mod Podge and the glue sticks. You can decide what works best for you. Now I'm deciding here which part of the napkin that I like the best, and I'm being sure not to get too close to the edge because that's where all the little polka dotted spots are where they have little holes, and I don't want that. So I'm just going to place it down here. I like what's on here, and I'm going to smooth it out. Now this is in fast motion because I don't want to bore you with all the details, but do understand that I'm doing this very gently. I'm going to trim off some excess here, and I did have a little tear in my little pumpkin's chin over there, but that's easily fixed. Okay, same thing here. It's still a little bit, you know, it's not completely dried yet, but that's okay. I'm just sanding a little bit, very gently, and then the paper will just flake away, essentially. Now, once that is done, I'm going to pick another sign, and I like this one, Wish You a Beautiful Halloween. I'm going to cut that out, leaving a white border, and I'm going to put it on here. Give me a thumbs up if you're enjoying this video. I sure appreciate it, and it does help my channel. Okay, I'm going to use some of these little foam stickers. I'm going to put these on the back to give it just a little bit of height and a little dimension. You could use the little dots that you get from Dollar Tree if you like, whatever you have. Or you can use another Jenga block and do it like that. There we go. You can put a bow on here. You can do whatever you like if you want to, you know, make it your own. To me, this is good just like this. I did try making a little bow, but nah, I like it like this. Little shadow box that you get from Dollar Tree. The one that I'm using is about a 6x6 square. If you want to get something similar, that's what I'm using. So I'm going to choose a paper. And since I've got bats going on pretty good bit in this bunch of projects, I think that this would be a cute option. It is a little bit bigger than my box, so I'm going to go around with the pencil, mark it, and then I'm going to use my little paper cutter and trim it off. I don't have a link for the exact paper cutter, but I will try to get you a link to something similar if you like the pendulum type paper cutter. I'm very happy with mine. Okay, using that glue stick, I'm going all over the flat back part of this little box. And I'm going to put my paper down. This is like a cardstock. It's kind of, it's thicker than regular paper. You know, craft paper. So I'm going to press it down nice and flat, and it fits fairly well on there. My sticker pack did not come with a moon, and I really want a moon on my scenery, so I'm just going to take some of these Dollar General stickers that I got for like 90% off 1 year, and I've had them forever. I'm going to use those by painting them and then putting them by the fan so they can dry. And while that's happening, I'm going around the edges and roughing up the edges. It's just more of a rustic look, and it is going to kind of burnish that down. The next step. Alright, I'm taking an artist pencil, but you can use any pencil that you want, and I'm just laying the side of the pencil lid down to give some shadowing on here. Now, I'm going to give the credit of this to Trish from Crafting Cousins, because she did this on one of her projects, and she said she always does it on a certain type of project, and I thought, you know what, that would be really good pretty much on anything. So I've taken her little tip, I'm giving her credit for it, and just going around the edges to give this an older, more aged, and rustic look. Gives it kind of a spooky look on the edges, if that's even a thing. It is now. That's a spooky look. We're going to call that a spooky look. Okay, so I'm going to take my little glittery haunted mansion, and I'm going to put it down. I'm not sticking it all the way down till I know where I want it. Got a little witch that's glittery. I'm going to put her up there in the top in the sky. I know I want her in the sky. Once I'm happy with that, I'm going to press those down. And they have the little foam stickers on the back too, so they stand up just a little. Gotta have more bats, right? You can never have too many bats. So I'm going to color some more, again with that same furniture marker. It took me several days to do all these projects, y'all, but I had a blast. I had my scary podcast going and the music sometimes, and I was having myself a blast. Now, it looks like there was an explosion in my craft room right now, but hey, I had fun, and I've got so much more to show you. I cannot wait to show you more. Okay, so the same little technique, going around the edges of that moon after it's nice and dry with the pencil, and then just kind of rubbing that edges out to kind of give it a dirty aged look, I guess. Oh, I love it. I love the way this looks. Thank you, Trish, for the idea. Okay, so far so good. Now we want to put our little bats in flight up there. And I like them hanging over the edges like that. But you know what? It's missing something. Why don't we put a jack-o'-lantern in there? And I think I'll do white. And I'm just going to take some white chalk paint and quickly go over this. I'm kind of using a dry brush. I'm not I'm not putting a heavy amount there. Let it dry, and then once it's dry, I'm going to start shading it with a pencil as well. I'm going to shade where it might would have its little stalk naturally growing, its little vine top. I'm just lightly coloring in a little bit there, and I'll take my thumb and just rub it into that chalk paint, and it will just smear so nicely and gives it such a nice little shadow. I'm going to go around in the eyes just a little bit. Darken those up, and yeah, I made a boo-boo there, but that's okay because I'm going to put some ribs on the pumpkin, so it won't even matter. I'm going to do the same thing here. I'm just going to blend those in a little bit. Isn't he cute? Oh my goodness, he's cute. Okay, so we're going to put him down here. It already has one sticker, but I'm going to add one more right on top of it so that it really stands out because the pumpkin is so much bigger. It's not in proportion, so we want it to look like it's standing out further than the castle. Like you're going to pass it going down the road before you even get to that castle or that mansion, whichever way you want to call it. So actually, I have three layers. It's really standing out there.
I'm going to take a pack of this scrapbook paper. You can get any type of scrapbook paper you want. You can get full size. All I had was the minis in the style that I wanted. And make a printable. You can go on Pinterest and get free printables or on Google and find some free printables. Just do it on white paper, any font you want. And I have chosen out of my scrapbook pack, four of these orange and black plaids. This pack originally came from Target, I believe, the Target Bullseye Playground, but I got it at Dirt Cheap. So I'm just going to use a glue stick here on the back and start piecing this together like a puzzle on the back of this sign. When I flip this over later in the video, you'll see the DIY that's on the other side that I did for fall. You want to line up, try to make sure your pattern is as even as possible. If that sort of thing is important to you, it definitely is to me. So I'm just using my hand to just crimp down the side to give myself a line of where I want this to be. I'm going to add a layer of glue to the back of the paper and put it on top of the back of the sign that already had the glue on it. I just want to make sure that it stays on here nice for me. And the good thing about a glue stick is you don't have bleed over, you don't have bleed through, there's no bubbling, so it's perfect. Just using my ruler here as a flat edge to smooth this out. And again, I'm crimping the corners, I'm pushing them down with my hands to give myself an idea of where I need to cut and get my lines. They don't have to be exactly straight because I'm going to use a sanding tool to get the edges off to make them even. But I'm just going to cut off the excess next to the edge of the sign. And then I'm using this Dollar Tree sanding block. It is so old, but it is still working great. And I'm just going to angle down and away from the project on the side. And it is going to give me a nice finished, finished edge, very clean edge. You see here that it's just sanding it and it's just peeling it off. You don't want to pull it because you don't want to pull your paper. But if you have a piece that's just hanging there, you can just gently remove that. And that's really all you have to do all the way around on your edges. This is great for a rustic or farmhouse look. And I don't know why I find it fun to do this, but I really like this. It's something very satisfying about it for sure. I didn't come up with this idea. Lots of crafters do this on YouTube. Okay. Just make sure you get it all off there. Now it's nice and smooth. So now I'm going to take my printed picture. I'm going to use my ruler to lay down there and to bend my straight edge. And then take my scissors and cut that off. And also trim around it to make it whatever size you want. I like that it has a black frame around this, but you don't have to use it. You could make your own frame, you make your own edge, whatever you want. And then once I get it cut down, I'm going to find the placement here. And going to take some double stick tape for this. You can get this at any crafter store. You can get it at Walmart. And I'm pretty sure you can get double stick tape at Dollar Tree as well. So I just want to center mine down. Now I've decided to take a bow. I will tell you that I tried a couple of other things, just, you know, thought of a couple of other ideas that I might like, but the bow seemed to be the simplest thing for what the look that I was going for. I want to try to finish using some of these ribbons that came from Dollar Tree. So I really love the black, white, and orange for Halloween this year. So I'm cutting 12-inch pieces. There's going to be three pieces, two for the bow, and there's going to be one for the tail. So there, I just finished off one roll. And actually, that last piece might not be quite 12 inches. It looks more like about 8 inches. Just going to twist up a tail there and start working on my bow. So this bow, I don't think I've made for you guys before. Simple enough. You fold your ends over. You want to overlap one a little bit more than the other. So if you say you overlap one inch on one ribbon piece, then you want to do 2 inches on the next one. That's going to leave you a space, and you'll see in just a minute where the bows will show both layers a little bit better. So just a little bit of glue here, just a little bit. And you want to make sure that you don't press it all the way down to the other layer. So you see me pull the bow apart to make sure that it dries without sticking to the bottom layer. Because if you do that, you won't be able to fluff your bow. And I want to be able to fluff this out. So I'm just making sure I got my space right there. And I have a smaller ribbon and a larger ribbon segment now. So I'm going to let that one kind of dry also. Okay, then I'm going to use some of this pipe cleaner or chenille stem, whatever you want to call it, came from the Halloween section of Dollar Tree. And I'm just going to stack these with the shorter or the smaller one on top, and you can see the bottom layer underneath when they're stacked. That's what you want to do. So I'm going to just pinch and push these together. Then I'm going to take my pipe cleaner, put it over the top, and then twist it in the back. This is going to hold it together nicely. Be sure you get that tight enough that when you fluff it, you don't pull your bows out of there, and that you have enough length left, because we're also going to attach the tails on the same piece of wire. What colors do you like for Halloween this year? Are you into the same colors, traditional colors, or what are you into? What do you like? Okay, so I'm just going to open it up, place it right in the middle, and then twist it tight. And there's the little tails. So I am going to dovetail the ends. You've seen this done before, really simple, cut upward in a triangle. All right, then you're going to add some glue on the back where it all meets together and place it down on your plaque. You can, of course, if you don't have one, a plaque that's rounded, you can use a rectangle, a square, whatever shape you like. Then I'm just fluffing that out. And there you have it. Pretty little sign. You can sit on your shelf if you have any floating shelves. And there's my project that you saw in my very first or second video. What do you think? So here it is with some more of my Halloween decor. You can see that I have a little theme going here with the black and orange.
Love that. Okay, so now we're going to go on to the next project. We're going to use some of these little felt banner pieces, I've got some ribbons, two different colored fabrics, and two of these monogram pumpkins from the Dollar Tree. You can see here, doesn't matter which letter you get because it's gonna be covered up. Tear off your bows. And I'm going to show you how you can separate this. This is my little metal ruler that I got from Dollar Tree, and I use this thing for so many things. If you slip this underneath there, you can gently pry apart the two layers. So you're going to pull upward a little bit, go around the edges, because it's only held there by glue. There are no nails. You can see the glue there. And we're going to do the bat pumpkin. We're gonna have two projects, one with each pumpkin. Okay, so you can see there's some weird damage over there on the left side of that pumpkin. I don't know what that was, but I bought it that way because I knew it wouldn't matter. I'm going to use my Mod Podge, give this a good thick coat all over this pumpkin, even on those little edges and around the stem. And then I'm going to lay down my fabric. Now, you can get fabric at Dollar Tree. You can get fabric at Walmart. You can use an old shirt. You can use an old dress, maybe from one of your children. You can use any type of fabric you want. A napkin, you know, like a cloth napkin. Mine did come from Goodwill. And then I'm gonna put on a thick layer of this Mod Podge. The reason we're sealing this in a thick layer of Mod Podge is because it will get hard and it's gonna be so much easier to cut and to sand.
I tried to sand down that S and it was a disaster, so I don't recommend that. Go over it instead with some white chalk paint. And that's what I've done here. It's thicker than regular acrylic paint. You might could use spray paint if you wanted to, but you're going to put a good thick coat on there and then make sure that it dries thoroughly. While that is drying, we're going to go on to the next pumpkin. We're going to mix two different color paints here to try to match the color of the pumpkin that we have. I didn't do a perfect job with this, but close enough. I just felt like I needed to cover up those spots that are down there on that pumpkin. You don't have to do this because you're gonna be covering it back up, but I did have a little bit of that was peeking out from underneath where that second layer was gonna go, and I did not want that to show, so. Just go ahead and do this, but you can skip this part if you didn't tear yours like I tore mine. So for the center section, we're going to use the black fabric. Just gonna cut off only what I need so I can save the rest of the fabric for another project. And we're gonna put this down with a little bit of hot glue. Protecting our fingers first, of course. You're gonna put the hot glue around the edges and then fold it over. I'm gonna do this all the way around the sides first. And then around the curves in the top, and then that top is finished off, and then around the bottom. Now I'm going to take the little ghost that I've picked here, and some of these will easily come off, so I'm just kind of removing the black eyes and the face because it looked like a scary face, and that's not what I'm going for in my projects. So it did take a whole day for this to dry, but once it's dry, you can just easily take your scissors and cut it like paper. Look how easy this comes off. Or you can use your little cutting knife, whatever you choose. But it is so thick and strong now that this heavy grit paper is filing it off like it's regular paper. Perfect. I love it. Now I'm going to add back the center section. You can a little bit still see that S under there, but it's not that big of a deal and it's going to be covered. So you could use a second coat of paint and let that dry if you'd like, but I'm good with this. We're gonna have a little bat right on top and you won't even be able to see. Don't worry about the holes, we're gonna fix that. So I'm just gonna put my little felt bat at an angle here. And then I'm going to glue around his little ears and the top of his head, any place that may be trying to come away. Go ahead and secure those down. Just put the tiniest little dots under there. I love my glue gun. So I'm going to use this glass writer, which I use for so many things that are not glass, and it is wonderful. It came from Dollar Tree. I'm going to fill in the holes where the ribbon went through for the banner when it was a little garland. Now I'm going to use a little bit of this silver to just give him some little eyes. I don't want him to have big white eyes, just a little hint of an eye. Wow, I sounded like Bob Ross, didn't I? Okay, so there we go. You can see his little eyes. And we're going to put this other pumpkin back together. He's going to be our ghost pumpkin. Gonna go over here. Excuse my head. And we're gonna put this little ghost down on here. Hot glue. Fix him right to the center. Just like that. Pressing it down. Now we've got to give him a face though, right? He needs a friendly face, just like the little bat. So I'm just going to make a smile. I'm going to use the original holes from the hanger as his eyes. And I'm going to draw him a U-shaped smile with the little dash right beside it. Now he's happy like the bat. Okay, I think to make them even cuter, we're going to put some messy bows on top. What do y'all think? Go ahead and use any type of bow you have. I'm going to just run through this little messy bow. These are 6-inch pieces that I'm using of different types of ribbon. None of them have wire. They don't need wire, so this is perfect if you have unwired thin ribbons laying around for maybe other projects. You can just stack those together. I'm going to make the first bow to coordinate with the pumpkin, and then we'll make a different color to go with the other pumpkin. So this is for the orange bat. I mean, not the bat. Oh my goodness. The orange pumpkin is going to look like this. I'm just going to tie it with another piece of the black ribbon, and then that way we don't even have to cut that off. It will be incorporated into the bow. So I'm just going to try to get close to my center, tie that tightly in a double knot. And then that's kind of what our bow is going to look like. You can go ahead and either dovetail your ends if that's the look that you like. You can cut them at a slant. You can leave them straight across. You can make little points. Do whatever you want to do on this. But I love doing it this way. And then the thin ribbons don't need any type of trimming on them, except trying to make them even, which is what I've done here. Folded them in the center, gathered them up, and just trimmed off the edge. And then this is what we have. I love adding that little jute in there. Just gives it a little more of a rustic look, and I'm all about that rustic life. All right, now see, isn't that cute? That's gonna look perfect. I used ribbons I already had, but the little checked ribbon is a ribbon that I got this year from Dollar Tree. Love that. It's a dark orange and it matches the pumpkin. Now the orange on this pumpkin is a little bit brighter, so we're going to change it up a bit. I'm going to use a brighter ribbon, and then I'm going to take some of the orange, some of the black, and some of the white, and then of course we're going to use a little more of the jute that we used in the other one. I'm going to cut those in pieces, layer them up. Doesn't really matter how you put these together, I just like to alternate. And then the three pieces of the jute on top, I'm going to take a little orange scrap that I already had. We're going to double knot that. We're going to fold it over, grab our edges, trim them off, and then there you go. Right above that second layer, I'm going to add the bow on here. And glue my finger down, apparently. That's why you should be protecting your fingers, and I didn't do it this time. Shame on me. Okay, so there we go. All right, this has got to be my favorite project. This is number 10, and if you're still here, please leave me a jack-o'-lantern. This thing is so cute. All right, so I'm gonna use a thrifted little stand. I'm going to use some spray paint to give it a good coat of paint. I'm gonna use some of these vase filler pieces from Dollar Tree. You can get raffia at Dollar Tree. I'm gonna use a couple of different colors. I'm gonna use some scrap pieces of floral foam, and I'm gonna use some of those wire cutters. I'm going to stuff the inside of my little cauldron, and you can get these at Dollar Tree as well. I'm going to stuff it with some scrap pieces of floral foam. This is just to fill it up so we have something to set our piece of paper on the top. I've taken a piece of paper, filled it straight in the top. It goes right down that lip and sits on top of the foam. Now we're going to start making the insides of whatever it is this witch has cooked up. So we're going to use black and orange bubbles. You can use any color you want, but I like black and orange and white. So that's what we're going to do here. I'm going to add dots of glue and put these down. Try to use a cool temp if you have a cool temp on your glue gun. Mine has two different temperatures because these are foam and they can melt. So just be very careful. And you see, that one stuck to my finger protector and came right off. Look at that. What a mess. You're going to keep adding. I'm just kind of going around and looking at the size of the holes and the shape and the color, and just adding in where I need to add in. So you can see there, I'm adding in little ones and big ones, just going around and around the top until the top is completely finished. You could definitely leave those little glue strings on there if you wanted to. Might give it a little extra creepy look. So there's the top of it so far. Here is our dried painted base. Love it. Very cute. Now we're going to use a wood circle to be the base of what we're doing next. Okay, so I'm going to take some of this straw and I'm going to almost like roll it into a nest, because this is going to be like the base of our fire. We're going to have a fire because we've got to have something cooking in that pot, right? Got to have it cooking in that cauldron. So I'm going to take some glue, take that spool that I have wound up there, place it down, and then I'm going to cut around it. This is easier for me to do it this way. You could certainly just go ahead and put that straight on the top of the little base riser that we have, but I didn't want to quite do it that way. I don't know why this particular raffia has knots in it. Just work around it. Now you're going to take this and wrap it around your four fingers. Just wrap it around there a whole bunch of times. Slide it off. And then you're going to cut it. And when you cut it, you've got two different sides here. Just like this. And this is going to be like a fire. Nice. So now you got to tie it together and get you another piece of that raffia. I should have done that before I cut it, but I didn't. Just to show you it can be done, go ahead and tie it in the middle so that nothing comes apart. Now, the darker the color, the closer to the bottom of the fire it should be, right? If you've ever looked at flames, that's kind of how it looks. I'm going to put my red on the bottom. This is like a dark orange, actually. I'm going to just glue it right in the center. It kind of looks like flames coming up, right? Now, this is what I should have done the first time. Wrap it around your hand, get your loops, get another piece, tie it. Then you're going to put your thumb on the knot, pull it up, cut it. Now you've got your orange layer. You can just trim that down however you want to trim it and put it across and inside the darker color one. Needs to be a little shorter, trim it up. Easy, easy. I'm going to put some glue there and just put it across or on top of the darker color there. It's almost like an X, but it doesn't matter. You can do it however you want, but this will keep it from being too bulky in the center. I'm pressing down really, really hard there to make sure that that glue goes all the way through to the base. Now we're ready to set the cauldron down. Fits perfectly down in there. So now we can go ahead and put it on the top of our little pedestal. Okay, now how's that? Pretty cool. It's so cute, I love this. Okay, so now I'm gonna take my glue gun and start putting bubbles over the side so it is bubbling down into the fire. You might want to use the smaller bubbles as you go down, but you don't have to. You can do this any way that you want to. I'm going to go back in and add things to the top, add things around the side. I'm just tilting it here so that you can see a little bit better what it is that I am doing. I could have cut all this out in editing, but I know some people need to see the details, so I'm just showing you how I kind of twist these and turn them and how I add these in. Be sure that you kind of alternate your colors. You can use some orange, you can use some black. It's going to give it some depth and some interest. And I'm just going all the way down and even onto the base there. So it is bubbled out and is spilled onto the base. You can also, if you run out of the small ones like I did, you can take some of the larger ones and just cut them with scissors and just glue that foam part straight down. And I think I left a part of that in there to show you how I do it. Let's see. Do I? I think I do. So here I'm just cutting. And then you can just put that down. And it gives it a little bit of a smaller bubble. Just like that. So you want to continue on. If you have enough and you want to go all the way down, you certainly can, but I wanted to stop right here on the base. Oh my gosh, I love this. But if we've got bubbles, we need smoke, right? So to signify steam or smoke or a witchy spell coming out of here, I'm going to make some curls out of one piece of my pipe cleaners. You can see I just made a little twist around a piece of stick that I have there, and I'm just going to poke these down in the empty spots. Oh, how cute. Would you have put those in there or left them out? I think it looks cute. I think it looks like steam coming out. Okay, so we're going to start off with some of these. They were from Target last year. They're actually wrappers that go around drink bottles. So I've chosen this one. They come in a variety pack. Probably can find them this year too. And I've cut mine down already to show you that it's going to fit the size of this thrifted shadow box that I got from Goodwill. I'm going to use some double stick tape to easily put this down. You could use hot glue, but it's going to make it a mess if you decide to repurpose it. So, a little bit of double stick tape will do the trick. I'm just using my little popsicle stick to flatten it down, make sure that the glue is sticking. And I've got this thrifted frame that I knew I wanted to use for Halloween, and it fits perfectly over this box. Just a coincidence. Going to use popsicle sticks to help give some support to the box when it comes to putting on the frame and keeping it in place. Just using my little nippers here that of course came from Goodwill, and it looks like they were very loved at one time. They're stained, but they are clean. Going to use some hot glue and make sure our sticks are the same length and that they're the correct depth for the box and the frame. And then we're going to set the frame back on top. Make sure that it fits correctly. If it doesn't, just go ahead and snip off a little bit more. You can use a few dots of hot glue underneath the edge of the frame to hold it in place, but I am going to use this 3M black tape. It's like a duct tape, but it's black. Seems to be the right width, and I know that it'll have a good strong grip. Just going to use it on the bottom of the frame, and then I'm going to do the same thing up there on the top. See, I've just flipped it over there. Okay, do y'all remember this cat? This cat was from one of the first videos that I did, either the first or the second one. He's one that had a different face, and I painted him all black and then started over. And I painted that. Just use some hot glue and put him on the corner. Then I'm going to take some of this Dollar Tree ribbon. It is wired, and I'm going to make a bow with it. And it's also this orange that is sheer. It actually has like a spider web pattern. It's really pretty, or a crackle pattern. So the two look really, they look good together, I think. And then I'm just going to make my bow. I've got a 6-inch tail, pinching it. And I'm going to make about a 6-inch loop. Pinch it toward the center. And then I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to flip it. And then there we go. All pinched toward the center. Just going to make sure my loops are even. Okay, then I'm going to, while I'm still holding on to the other one, I'm going to do the same thing for this Happy Halloween ribbon. I'm going to have a 6-inch tail. I'm going to make 2 6-inch loops. And they're all going to be stacked together. Just a little bit of fluffing. Get a good grip on the bow, and then we're going to add that tie there, the little zip tie. Now I'm just curling and fluffing again and deciding on placement, and I'm also going to dovetail, and I think I've also heard this being called fishtails, but I'm going to dovetail the ends, which is just cutting a V in the ends. Okay, for the center to cover up that tie, I'm going to fold a strip of that bow in thirds. Then I'm just going to wrap it around to the back, add some glue on the tied area, press it down, got my little finger protector on there, and then I'm going to fold the end up and glue it down. If you need to, go ahead and clip that off so that it's not sticking up on the top of your bow. Now I'm going to add some glue and secure my bow. Here's one of my laundry clips from the Dollar Tree. You can get those in, I think, a pack of 6. Some are white and some are blue. They're really handy for these thicker projects. Okay, so I've decided that my kitty cat down there deserved a little bit prettier of a bow, a little more festivity. So I've just taken a little scrap of this orange ribbon that came also from Dollar Tree, and I've used the jute to tie it in the middle. And I'll snip that off. It's just a little simple bow. And I'll be using some hot glue to attach that to his original bow. Okay, so I've taken this little plastic spider, and I'm just going to stick him down because I think he looks good on the webs, and going to fluff up that bow. I want to be sure that I'm curling the tails under, and I'm just doing that with my fingers. It's really easy to do. And so I've decided, since my paint, it doesn't have very good coverage here, to just take a chalk marker. It's either the chalk marker or metallic marker from Dollar Tree, and fill in over the original area that I painted to make that white pop a little bit better. And then when that is done, I'm going to take a black, it's actually a glass marker. It has got a great fine tip on it, so almost like a paintbrush tip. I love it. And I'm going to use that to trace out that area. And it really makes it look a lot better. This is a permanent marker also.
And that looks much better, I think. Okay, so here it is without the light. Well, with the light still on, actually. But you can see behind the cat and up there toward the tail of that bow where the spider is, you can see that I have some little Dollar Tree flickering Halloween tea lights. In a minute, I'm going to show you what that looks like when we turn off the lights. I think it turned out so adorable. So there you can see a little bit of a light flickering. My smiling cat, I'm very pleased with him. He looks happy there. I'm glad I got to use him. Okay, so here it is with the lights dimmed. Is that not the cutest thing ever? You could also use some of the little fairy string lights if you wanted to. Any way that you want to do it, but these do fit down in there. There's two. There's one in the left bottom, and then there's one in the right bottom side, kind of behind the cat's head.
We're going to start with the wreath form that comes from Dollar Tree, but I believe you can get it other places. This is the one that's dimensional. It's not flat. We're going to take some picks, and my choice is going to be black and orange, and I think I add some yellow later to match the candy corn. Little burlap leaf came from Dollar Tree. The little wispy piece came from Dollar Tree, and this fabric came from Dollar Tree. Can you believe it? And it's the perfect size for this form. All right, so we're going to start by covering our form with this black fabric. Of course, we want to remove our tag, and then watch how perfectly this piece of fabric fits with this form. I could not believe it when I tried it. Yes! So you can pick any color of that seasonal fabric that you can find at Dollar Tree, or you can use the solid felt fabric, whatever you can find. You can even use an old shirt, an old skirt, an old blanket or sheet, whatever you like. So I'm just clipping this and then flipping it over so I can see where I'm going to be needing my glue. I don't have arms like an octopus, which would be ideal for this because I could hold everything at one time while I'm gluing, but since I can't, these clips work great, and they came from Dollar Tree. They got little silicone tips on them, so they grip really nicely for these projects. All I'm doing is going around the edge and just kind of laying it out where I know I want it to be. Just like this, and then we'll trim off that excess in a bit, but for now I'm just going to put it where I know I want it to be, and then we're going to work with one section at a time. So I'm going to unclip the section on the side first using my cool temperature setting on my gun, because you do not want this to run off of that wire. If you use a high temp, it's going to fall off the wire. We don't want that to happen. We need a little time to be able to adjust that fabric to fold it over the edge. So you having that cooler temperature glue is going to work better for that. Then I'm going to go to the other side and then attach that side down. See how that bead sits right on top? That's perfect. That's what we want. I'm not going to stretch it too hard, because if you stretch too hard, these frames will bend, and I don't want to change the shape of this pumpkin. So I'm just going to follow the natural form and wrap around the edges. I'm going to continue to do that all the way around this pumpkin. I'm going to do a little bit at a time. So I've done both sides. Now I'm going to go to the bottom. And you get the idea here. Folding it over, squeezing it down so that the glue goes on both pieces of fabric and on the wire form. So we're going to continue around like this. I wanted to let y'all know, guys, this is a little hidden giveaway. I'm having a 5,000 subscriber giveaway, so if you haven't subscribed, be sure that you do that. I'll be giving you more details later on that, but I can tell you that the giveaway is going to be a box full of goodies, things that I have thrifted for crafting, things that I've picked up from Dollar Tree, extras, there'll be ribbons, probably transfers in there, maybe fabric, tools, paints, all kinds of things. So when we get to 5,000 subscribers, we're going to have a giveaway. Stay tuned so you'll know what to do. Okay, so when we get up to the stem and we've gotten everything else glued down, I'm just going to clip there around the stem so that I can trim off everything and still have a little bit on the top to work with. We're going to do that in just a second. Sharp scissors really do help. I've heard that you can sharpen your scissors by cutting on a piece of sandpaper or cutting on aluminum foil. Now, do your own investigating to see. I don't want anybody to ruin their good scissors, but I have used it on sandpaper before on my scissors, and it works great. So try that at your own risk. All right, so just around the top here, now I have this little flap for the top of my pumpkin. It isn't the perfect fit, but it'll work for what I need. I'm just gonna fold it over. You can see I'm a little bit out of camera range, and I apologize for that. I think I've gotten much better. If you've watched my videos from the beginning, I've gotten much better about trying to stay where you can see me, but you know, sometimes in the heat of the moment, things happen. All right, now there's a bunch of different types of ribbons that you can use. Whatever you want to use to trim yours out, you can. I just tried a few different types. I like this particular ribbon because it's wide enough that I can put glue on it and put it right down the center of those wire pieces without any glue coming out the sides. If you use a very thin strip, you might have an issue with glue seeping through. And I'm always striving to make a high-end look, and I want to show you how to do those little extra things to give you a high-end look. So we're going to start at the top, right beside the stem on that first ring, and you can almost see through the fabric here, so you can see it. And you just want to lay that down and add a little bit of glue as you go. You don't have to put a whole string of glue there unless you just want. I found that with the cooler temperatures, when you put a dot and then pull down to another dot, you pretty much get a little stream anyway. It's just like a little string, but it's plenty to hold that ribbon in place. Then nothing will show through. There'll be no bulk from the glue underneath, and you'll get a nice smooth appearance, and that's what we want. So we're gonna go down just like this, gonna flip it over, add some glue on the underneath section, and then press it down, and then trim off right there. So the ends are on the back side, and it's nice and smooth. I'm going to show you again. We're going to start here, a little bit of glue. Press it down and squeeze it to the back. Some of the glue goes to the back of the form. You can see the little string, little spider web of glue between the dots, and that's perfect for this. I'm going to add some glue here, flip it over, little dot of glue on the back, squeeze it down, and trim it off. Be sure you use those clamps when you need them. All right, this is it when it's completely finished on the base of the pumpkin. Now we're going to use a little bit of this burlap. Use whatever you have. This really doesn't show too much in the end with the design that I use, but whatever you decide you want to use, you could wrap with ribbon or burlap or jute, or leave it just like it is, whichever way you want to do it. But I like this black burlap, so I'm going to add this to the top. And it's this particular burlap, I'm just going to be honest, I can't remember where I got it from, but it is ridiculous to work with. It is really, I can't. So it's best that I use it up, right? Why not use it on a place where it really doesn't show that much? It frays, it comes apart, and it has that white backing. I can't. Anywho, moving along. So now we're going to make a little swag for the top. And here we have this nice and glittery pick from Dollar Tree. I think it's called Willow, I'm not sure, but they have these in a couple of different colors this year. And I'm going to take my thrifted oak picks and just lay those around to see where I want them to be. And you can see that I've left an open spot in the middle, and then we have similar sides. I'm going to say similar. They're definitely not identical, and I'm not trying to make them identical. Using a black zip tie, which also came from the Dollar Tree, I'm going to cinch those down really tightly. I do, by the way, glue that leaf back on. And decide where I want to put it. Look at this. Ugh, the fallout. It's horrific. Ah! Okay. Now, you've seen me make this if you've seen my last... Let's see. Which video did I do where I made all these little things? Oh, yes. It was a Halloween, vintage Halloween video. I'm going to take this and wrap it 20 times around my hand. These are pieces of raffia, a black. If I'd had a white, I would have added that in there, but I did not have any white. I'm not even sure they make white. Tie it in the center right here with some jute in a double knot. Trim it off. I'm going to press it down so that I can see where the center would be, and I'm going to cut right through that center there. This is similar to what you would do with making a tassel, but we're not going to make a tassel. This is going to almost be like a flower or a little pile of hay or straw. It's just really cute looking to me, and it looks rustic, and it reminds me of, I think I've said it before, but it just reminds me of something carnival-like. I don't know. All right, so I'm going to wrap that around. It's convenient to have that jute long enough that you can use it to tie. And I don't cut that stuff off until the end. That way I can use it if I need to. I'm going to fluff it out a little bit. It's a nice little filler. I think it gives some great color there amongst all the black. Okay. Now I'm going to take this burlap leaf. I think this is a maple leaf. Really doesn't matter. It's orange and it looks good here. It's going to break up some of that black. I'm going to press it in with that long little wire piece on the back and then just kind of fluff that other stuff over the top. I've got a variety of gold and yellow flowers here. I also have an orange flower that you'll see in a second. These two branches are thrifted and they are identical. So I'm going to pull the same branch off with the same little pick part off of each branch. Do you see what I'm saying? Yeah, they're identical. And I'm going to put one on each side. And then fluff it around a little bit to get it where I want it. I didn't have to use glue because this fits right down in the other stems from the other picks, which makes it great. But feel free, if you're going to hang it outside where it might get some wind and weather, that you would, you know, go ahead and use a little hot glue there. But I don't need it for that because it's going to be indoors. Look at this beautiful orange thrifted flower. Love it. Rather than shoving that down in that pick, which is already pretty tight, I'm just going to use a little hot glue on the back. And this is still my cool temp. I'm enjoying using the cool temp, actually. And then I'm going to put my flower right down in there. I'm just going to press it down for a minute until that glue has a chance to set up. So now we have a beautiful floral spray for the top of our pumpkin. Love it. But we're not done yet. We're not done yet. Okay, so I'm going to take that jute. I'm going to wrap it around that wire frame and then tie it off. Just like that. Trim it down and then a little hot glue to keep that knot from slipping. Once it's cool, you can flip it over so you don't glue it to your table. And I need a hanger. So right in the top, there's a piece of the wire that is still easy to expose underneath the burlap. So I just press it down a little bit and then wrap a piece of that coordinating ribbon, the same ribbon, to make a hanger. Just like that. And I'm going to cut this at a slant because I want the knot to be at the top. I like the look of that. So that's what we got so far, but we have one more thing we're going to add. But you can stop there if you like. Okay. So the icing on the cake. Dollar Tree has these cute little signs. I was lucky enough to get two packs, and they're different. The signs are shaped differently. It's going to fit nicely on the sign, I think. So I'm going to just take my little tie here, go right underneath my swag, and then attach it down, and then trim it off. It's hanging from a wire, so you really could adjust that up to make it shorter or down to make it longer. But I love the look of this. What do you think? Okay, now, number two, candy corn pumpkin sign. I am going to be featuring some of Plaid's products. I am glad to say that I am an ambassador for Plaid, and they sent me a bunch of goodies. Three paints here are the candy corn colors I have chosen, and then a pack of brushes. This came from them as well. This is a sign that I printed off a few years ago, believe it or not. I hung on to it because I like the font. And then this pumpkin that came from Dollar Tree. We're going to use the back. All right, I'm going to put some paper towels down here to just protect my surface and cut the hanger off of my pumpkin. I'm going to start with a flat brush. I love painting with these brushes. It's so soft and it gives such a nice stroke. Really like these. Thank you, Plaid. I appreciate so much all the wonderful goodies I got. Okay, so we're gonna start off with this beautiful yellow. I'm gonna put this on the bottom. And this is almost gonna be like an ombre effect. I'm still working on my technique, so forgive me. This is for inspiration, guys. This is definitely not gonna be perfect. And you'll see what I mean in a bit. So if you're somebody who crafts and then you get disappointed in yourself because it doesn't turn out quite like you wanted it to, oh, just watch what happens to me and be inspired that, you know, we can always try harder and we can learn from our mistakes. Next, we're going to take this beautiful orange. I believe this is pumpkin orange or harvest orange. It's gorgeous, though. I'll put the colors in the description box for you. All right, so the same brush with the yellow on it. I'm just going to go up and start blending a little bit of that orange into the yellow. You can see it's kind of smeary looking. Okay, so this is where it goes wrong. I put the white on and forget to change brushes. Now, with white paint, it's... I should have just used a different brush because now I have a mess. And I will tell you that I had to keep adding it. Then I had to let it dry and add two more coats just to get the white right. Mm-hmm. And my line is not straight. And it doesn't matter that much until you get ready to put words. Ugh! Then it's a mess. So we're going to let that disaster dry. And we're going to go on to our light up scarecrow box. We're going to take this little sign from Dollar Tree. It's a triangle. Any type of little chipboard or wooden or whatever embellishment that you have. Any type of little guys. And then a napkin. This is just a paper napkin. I'm going to take this tag off the back because it's... Well, it doesn't look good there, and we're not mini pearls, so we're going to take that right off. Sometimes they come off easily, sometimes they do not. Just going to do the best I can with this. The struggle is real. With these signs, you can press the back right out. Just like that. And sometimes, just like today, it'll peel off nicely. Sometimes, it will not. If it doesn't, slap some chalk paint on it. Put it underneath the dryer and call it a day. But look at that. Perfection. Love it. All right, then be sure you clean up your frame as well because we want a nice, clean form to work with. That stuff will come off of there pretty easy. If not, just go ahead and get you a emery board or sanding block and just smooth that down. All right, so I know that I'm going to use this napkin on here. And I want to show you what you can do to separate your layers because I know for a lot of people, they say they can't get their two layers apart. If you tear above those little dots, if you notice the napkins have little dots on them, tear just above it, then your layers will come apart. Those little dots actually hold those layers together. So carefully, carefully. So you see there, you can get that to come apart and then very carefully go around and pull those areas loose. And then you have a one ply piece to work with. And that's easier. If you use two plies, in my opinion, that's when you're going to get the wrinkles. Okay, another plaid product. I'm going to put a little Mod Podge in the little cup beside me, but you can certainly use, just put it right down on top of your project. The reason I did it this way, and I'm using a new brush, is that I want to get a nice, even, light coat. I don't want to put too much on there and then not be able to take it off. So just using a little cup will help me get that light coat on there. I want a light coat because I have some things that I want to do with this project quickly so that you guys can see it. But you can use a heavier coat if that's what you like. I'm just using my hands to press the wrinkles out of the napkin now. There's some lines, some fold lines in there that we want to take out. So I'm just kind of gently pressing that out. I've learned how much pressure I can use with these napkins and with tissue paper. You have to kind of learn those. So I'm going to line these up. I don't want my dots, the napkin dots as we discussed, to show. So I'm just going to put it down where it's centered. This little tool here, I'm going to gently, gently, gently use this little rubber tool to press out my wrinkles and lines. Now, this is a faster speed. You would not do it this fast. Normally, you might tear something, so you don't want to do that. But go ahead and get that nice and neat. Work from the center outward so you can get all, you can press all those wrinkles and any other problems out to the edge. Now, because I used a light layer of that Mod Podge, I can gently tear away my edges without worrying about my paper coming apart or sliding off. I'm just going to, where I have pressed down on the edges, I'm just going to gently pull that paper away. I'm not trying to tear it. I'm just kind of pulling off where it will give naturally. Then I'm pressing my edges back down to make sure nothing comes loose, just pressing those down. Then I'm going to take my sanding block, which is a nice foam block that comes from Dollar Tree, and I'm going to use that to just shear that off on the edges. Gently downward and away. So there we go. You can see how we're doing that. All the way down. You're just going to follow your line all the way down. And there you go. Nice finished edge. If you haven't already subscribed, I would love to have you as part of my family. Our YouTube channel is growing. Okay, so we're going to put the backing back on our triangle. Just like so. A little bit of glue comes out, not a problem. We're going to press it down and it'll just kind of ball up and roll off. Get that stuff off of there. You don't want that showing in your final project. We want a high-end look. So I've chosen the scarecrow. I think when I saw the scarecrow, I actually thought, oh, I know exactly what I'm going to do here. So I'll show you the little theme with the scarecrow. Now, I don't like everything laying flat. You know that if you've watched my videos. I just like a little dimension. It's just more interesting in my opinion. I'm going to use some of these little, I don't know if they're like cardboard or what, but they came from Target originally. I happen to have gotten mine from Dirt Cheap. And you can just, I'm kind of getting an idea how I want this to be because I want this to look like a pumpkin patch. If you want to show me some love, do you know you can buy me a coffee? See the link in the description box below. Thank you. All right, I've got some of this. I think this is called creepy cloth that you get at Dollar Tree. And I've just kind of made a mess of it and I'm cutting it off and I'm going to use it on the bottom sort of like straw or like, you know, when you've been in a field and everything's been harvested and you've got all that extra stuff out there, well, that's how we want this to look. And it's a little creepy. You know, creepy cloth. Now we need to decide where the scarecrow is going to go. I think I like him there. But there needs to be a little more something. So we're going to put this pumpkin flat down. I'm going to put hot glue on it. That's what you're not seeing. And I'm going to place it down, pressing it down a little bit into that little, our little air quote hay on the bottom. I'm gonna layer my cute little scarecrow on that. I'm gonna put two of those blocks together and then glue them down so they're up even higher toward the front. I'm gonna put a pumpkin, the little hot glue, right there. So you can see my scarecrow is already hiding in the pumpkin patch. Just like that. Then I'm gonna take a pumpkin on the outside of the box right here, making sure that he doesn't hang down to interfere with it standing up. So be sure that you got your edges correct. And then a little hot glue here for another orange pumpkin. And look at all that depth and dimension. Is that not the cutest? But wait, it gets even better. We're gonna put a light in there. That's right. We're gonna put a light down there. Okay, so the problem I had was this little candle light from Dollar Tree is a little bit thick and it doesn't want to go in there. But there was a happy accident, as you can see right there. It came apart. It's actually almost flat without that top case. And it still works. So check this out. Uh-huh. What about that? That's cute, isn't it? Oh, I love it. I did one for Christmas, like a light-up Christmas box that turned out so cute. Okay, so now we're back to our dried pumpkin. I'm going to go around the edges of this pumpkin and between the layers of paint with my little sanding block. I want to rough it up just a little bit, and obviously the paint job is not perfect, so I want it to almost look like it was intentionally done that way. I'm working hard to make this thing work. I'm really working hard. I didn't want to scrap it though because I knew it would turn out nice, and I want it to be for inspiration for you. So again, not perfect, but hey, we're going to go with it. So, I'm going to use some carbon paper. I got this at the thrift store. I'm going to cut a piece of it to fit on the back and then tape it down. This way it won't slide all over the place and I'll get it exactly where I need it on the words. Okay. I haven't used carbon paper since I was a child, so let's see how this works. I'm going to place it over the pumpkin and try to find what I think would be the center of the pumpkin. You can certainly measure or cut that top paper down if you, you know, use a printable that is large like this. And by the way, if you go over to my Pinterest at Making It My Own One, you can find lots of free printables. So click on the free printables, and I put a lot of things there that you can look at. They're not my printables. They belong to other people. I've just made a board to make it easier for you guys. So you can go over there and choose something and print it out so you can make your own. Now I'm tracing over every bit of this. I'm going to do all of the little swirly designs, the lines under it, and all of the words on here. I'm trying not to press down too hard. Okay, there we go. How's that? Turned out pretty good. I think that's a really good transfer, especially for it being my first time in a very long time. But you see the problem here? Trick or treat is centered, but my lines between the paint are not. So we're going to go with this imperfection. We're just going to go with it. It's driving me nuts, but we're going to go with it. Now you're just going to take some type of a paint pen or maybe even a Sharpie, whatever you choose. These are acrylic paints, so they're fairly easy to go over. They don't eat away the paint, sort of like if you use chalk paint. If you've ever done that and tried to use a paint pen, sometimes you have to keep tapping it to get the paint come down. This is not a problem with these acrylic paints. So I'm just going to trace over with my paint pen, and I have they're paint markers. I have a thin and a thick, and I'm just going to use them accordingly. I'm going to first outline my letters before I paint them. I'm trying to use a level, even hand here, and you want to be sure that you're not dragging your hand through where you're painting. So just turn your pumpkin whichever way you need to keep your hands and your wrist out of those areas. So now I'm just going to color in all of my text just like this. I cannot remember where I got this printable originally, so I'm sorry about that, but you can find something that's comparable. Okay, so it's driving me nuts here, but you know, okay, I'll try not to obsess. We're gonna go over those little holes there, which I should have done in the beginning, but I forgot. And we're just going to put a little bit of that drywall putty in there, and then using my silicone, I'm just smoothing it off. It'll dry and it'll be fine. You won't be able to notice it very much. But so this is kind of crooked. So this is what I do. I go in there and try to fix it. I don't know what I was thinking, but I thought, oh man, maybe I can fix this. But no, because you know why? All of those letters are in the way. So I'd have to go in there and try to go between all of the letters. And then I just thought, you know what? This is ridiculous. I'm not even going to be bothered by it. So to distract from my errors, I'm going to make a very pretty little bow to go on the top. I've chosen three different coordinating ribbons, and I'm going to use four stacks of those. They are 5 inches, and I'm going to make a little messy bow. You can see what I'm doing right here. I am just crisscrossing. When you have an odd number, it's easy to just stagger these out. If you have an even number, it's a little different, but whatever, you know. If you're not obsessive about patterns like I am, then you won't have to worry about that. Some things just bug me. Okay, so I'm going to use a ribbon to tie the center. Just like this. I'm pulling and adjusting to make sure that I have pretty much the right length so that I don't have to do too much trimming in the end. Just making sure they're in the center. And then I'm going to slowly pull that knot. I don't want my ribbons to line back up again. I want them to stay in that X pattern. So little double knots here. Then you can go through with your scissors and trim the edges if you would like. You can dovetail if you want to. You can cut them at a slant if you want to. Whatever you want to use. Hey, if you want to use these, you got a good quality ribbon and they're not going to fray, you can use them just exactly how you cut them originally. And you can skip this step. But for me, I'm going to cut them at a slant. All right, we're going to use that same ribbon, flip it over, tie it, just like that. And by the way, you can use any pumpkin form you find at Dollar Tree. or wherever else for that matter. Anything will work. A little hot glue to make sure that doesn't slip up that stem, because it'll fall if it does. And then I'm just going to try to sand over here. Sand over my words to make them blend a little bit better. And I think I did somewhat fix my line there, somewhat. But I'm gonna go back over everything, kind of dull out that black. It's a little too dark there. See, I'm sanding in between, trying to ombre out my little colors, kind of smear them into one another. And originally I was gonna put this on a backing, but I decided against it. These are just pieces I had left over from last year and some from this year. I'm going to use some fastener dots or some Velcro pieces. I have some thrifted, this is like burlap with lace on the other side. I think it's a table runner. And then I got this from the thrift store as well, but it originally looks like came from Target. You can use any pumpkin form you want for this, especially if it has little cutout eyes. So I'm just going to lay it down here. I'm going to cut off some excess to make it a little more manageable. Then what you won't see is me tracing it out with a marker and then just trimming it down as close as I can to the form. Voila, there we go. I want my burlap side to show through his eyes, and the alternate side is going to be this pretty lace. So I'm going to protect my fingers, go around with my glue gun. Excuse my face in the picture here. We're gonna go all the way around, and I'm just gonna do it on the edges because I don't want any bubbles, wrinkles, problems of any sort. And this seems to be the easiest way to do it. Just around the edge, attaching it down. If you have any extras, just go ahead with your scissors and trim it. Make it look very neat. We always strive for a high-end look, so let's clean it up where we can. So now we have two sides. One side is going to be for Halloween. And we're going to use these little Velcro dots. Be sure you clean your surface, just like it says. I found that alcohol and a paper towel work great for this. You can go ahead and take your two dots. I always like to put the prickly part of my Velcro downward just so I remember where they are. And that's going to be important in some crafts that we're going to do shortly. So just keep that in mind. I'm going to go ahead and put those together and just press them down on the stem of that pumpkin. They are adhesive. You don't necessarily have to use the glue, but if you use a heavy bow or a larger bow, it's going to pull down and it may take it off of your surface. So just for a little extra safety there. Now I'm going to show you this fairly easy bow. This is what Ramon at home calls a funky bow. I am using 2 feet of each one of these ribbons, so 24 inches. And these are just my little scraps I showed you. I'm going to fold them in half. They're already dovetailed, and I'm going to pinch them in the middle and kind of pleat them together. Hold them between my thumb and my forefinger there. Hold them tightly together once you get them pinched off. Just see what I'm doing. Struggling here. There's always a struggle. This one was kind of wrinkled, so I was trying to work with the wire there. It's kind of flimsy, that ribbon. Now, the orange and white is a very good quality ribbon. It really holds its shape nicely. But I'm gonna do what I can with that checked ribbon because I really wanted to use it in this project. Now, onto the handy dandy zip ties. Love these. I'm gonna just cinch them around right in that center where I was holding them. I'm making sure that my loops are the same height there before I fasten it all the way down. Then I'm gonna cut it off, trim down my little extra here. This one I didn't cut. Okay, and so now you can fluff this mess of a bow out. It looks kind of wild in the beginning. You may question your choices, but I assure you it will look better. So you're going to pull things apart. I'm showing you at normal speed for a moment. Just pulling apart, separating my colors so that I don't have two patterns right next to each other. That's the goal anyway. And then you're going to start pulling the little ends upward. Pull them upward into the bow. So they're going to essentially form the base. So imagine that those loops are the flower and all these little tails are the leaves. So you want these leaves to go out beside your flower, right? That's what we want to do. Sometimes these fabric pieces of ribbon will fray. You can leave it that way or you can trim it up to make it look really pretty. Okay, so now that you don't have to see all of my fluffing, because I can go on and on and on with this, I put it in a quicker speed for you, but you get the idea. You want to just kind of twist and turn and fluff. Separate your patterns as best you can, and when you get it the way you like it, I'm just going to add a little glue here so that I can get a good strong hold with my bow onto the fasteners. I'm going to press down to make sure it goes through the fabric of the bow. I got glue on my table. Okay, so now you can curve down or pull straight out on your little wired ribbon. And if I didn't say that before, you definitely need a wired ribbon for this bow. But it's a great way to use your scraps, right? So now my cute little pumpkin has a little headdress. I'm gonna add a little more to it, of course. So I'm going to take some of these blackberries and some of these orange berries that came from the Dollar Tree. I'm calling them berries. I'm not sure what it says on the pack, but that's what they look like. So you can just pull those apart easily. They're just wound together. And I'm going to do some alternating picks of two orange and one black, and then two blacks and one orange. You can just twist those around each other and then bend the ends up, and it makes a good surface for you to add your glue so you can press them down into your either into the bow or wherever you want to put yours. I always like to remind people when you come over to watch my videos that what I do is for inspiration. You don't necessarily have to do it the same way I do. Certainly if you don't like the technique or you don't like what I'm doing, you don't have to. I just share this for inspiration. So we're going to continue around here. Just like that. And there you go. I'm only going to use four of these. Now I want to add a little more something to the top. It feels like it's too heavy in the center. I'm going to kind of broaden out the bow just a little bit by adding two of these orange leaves. They kind of coordinate somewhere between the color of the pumpkin and the color in my ribbon, because they are not exactly the same, but that's okay. That is okay. Any kind of orange works for fall and Halloween, right? So put these in wherever it's pleasing to your eye, wherever you like it, whatever brings you some joy. That's what this crafting journey is all about, right? Finding some joy, sharing, inspiring other people. So there we go. And I'm going to add one more just in the bottom here. Just like that. Okay. So there we go so far. What do you think? Yes, I think she's very pretty. She's looking great, ready for Halloween and happy about it. Okay, so now we're gonna work on the reverse side. So because we have those little glue dots, it's very easy to take that bow off and set it aside. We're gonna flip it over and start working on our fall side. Now the fall can be used early harvest, and then you can use it for Halloween. Then you can flip it back around and use it all the way up until Thanksgiving. That's my idea. Okay, so same process with that glue dot. We're gonna stick them together and then stick them down. I've got some burlap leaves and another scrap of ribbon, this beautiful, beautiful ribbon. I'm so sad I'm running out of it. And it came from Dollar Tree. It's just absolutely stunning. It has like a coppery color edge on it. It's really nice. It's also a wired ribbon. I'm gonna do 2 feet or 24 inches. Go down, cut that off. I'm gonna dovetail it just like the other one. And then I'm gonna make the simplest bow ever for this side. Certainly, when you finish your pumpkin, you could definitely go on to use this side for anything you want. Any type of bow, you don't have to put a bow. You can put a beautiful spray or swag across the top, anything that you choose. Very simple bow, and then I'm gonna tie it in the center with a piece of jute. Just like that. Always a double knot. We don't want it to come apart, because if you are a aggressive bow fluffer like I am, you want to be sure that you're not going to pull the bow completely apart. I'm a busy mama. I have little kids in my house, so I need to be sure that I save time where I can. And that's a good way to assure that I am using my time properly and I don't have to go back and redo anything I don't have to. So you see the back of these burlap leaves have a wire on them already. You can twist them together and then just add a little bit of glue, just like that, and it will secure them together nicely. You can also, if you don't intend to give any dimension or fluff on those leaves, you can just pull those wires off easily on the back. I'm going to trim off this because I'm not going to need it to tie anything. We have our glue dots. I like the way that's going to look, so I'm going to add a little bit of glue there and attach those together, just like so. A little more glue is going to attach it right onto the bow. Hey, if you haven't subscribed to my channel and you're new here, I would love to have you as part of my YouTube family. Okay, so again, because I had to flip my bow over, it smushed down just a little bit. I'm going to fix it just a tad. You can curl those edges or tails of the bow under with your fingers if you would like, or when you have wire, you also have the ability to just let them lay out straight. Whichever way you choose is great. Now they're even. And this is so simple. This side is so much easier. Excuse my head. I stand up sometimes to do my projects, especially when I have larger pieces like this and I need to be able to get a better view for you guys. So I stand up and sometimes my head gets in the way of the camera. Okay, there we go. Now we're gonna add one more bit, and this is a pack of three that you can get from Dollar Tree. I got them early in the season, so you know they may be out, so you can use something else. I just stippled on a little bit of this copper paint. I used two coats and let it dry. And now we're going to add it on to the sign. You have to work very quickly when you're using hot glue and metal because it dries so fast it'll try to pop off. So I've went ahead and put it exactly where I want it, and I'm just pulling it up on the edges, right around the thickest parts of that metal so that I can glue it down. If you want something that's going to be permanent, you can go ahead and add some super glue or anything like that. You can use Gorilla Glue in your hot glue gun, and that'll hold it for a long time. Best thing about this is you can't see the glue strings. So if you make a little bit of a mess, you're not going to see it on that pattern. What do you think? There's our harvest pumpkin. And coming up next, there's the Halloween pumpkin. All right. I like them both, and I will be using both of these in my home for sure. Give me a thumbs up if you like these. She's a beauty. She knows it. She's confident. And then you can make your own little cutouts. All right, third project. I'm going to use this little squatty candle stand. I'm going to use a Halloween sign from Target and a pumpkin patch sign from Hobby Lobby. I'm going to use some of these ornaments from Dollar Tree. I've got some picks from Dollar Tree. These are just some little random pieces of sticks and bobs from my collection. And then I'm going to use three of these, whatever these are, fall rounds with leaves on them. I've cut my floral foam ball in half, and I'm putting it right in the center. I'm going to take my first ring and put it down. I'm going to push my leaves outward as much as possible. Make sure that it's nice and even. We're not gluing this down. You don't even have to glue it. You can change it for another time. Now we've got to find some way to put our signs down in here. I'm going to use this little stick. You can use a popsicle stick, anything you want to use to make a standing or a pick sign out of these signs. I'm going to use scrap of ribbon from a project we did earlier. Cut these pieces off because we're going to need a little extra something something to hold this down to secure it. I'm going to use my glue gun. Press this down. Try to get it centered because I did not have it centered the first time. I'm going to put a little glue over the top and then a little piece of this ribbon. If you don't have scraps of ribbon, you can use a piece of scrap paper that you have to help hold it in place. And there you go. Welcome to our haunted house. I'm going to put it aside and let it dry. I'm going to work on this one. Because this sign is heavier, I'm going to use a dowel rod, a little piece that I have here. I think it came in a popsicle or cake pop kit or something like that. You got to think outside the box. Set it aside, let that glue set up nicely. We're going to start with our Halloween side first. You can take the little hangers off of these balls here. And there's glittery ones, there's shiny ones, and the mat. I decided to use the mat. These little sticks will fit down in here. Make sure that you find the right sticks to fit in there. Clip them down if you want to. And then you're going to be hot gluing them, of course. For the next ring, we're going to cut an inch section out, remove it, overlap it about a half an inch, and then we're going to have our next layer. You're going to press those together, and you're just going to hold them there. And you can clamp them down just like that until the glue sets up. It'll kind of melt. It'll kind of, you know, do its thing. And you'll have a different diameter to go on top. So you can stack it on top. All right. So here we are stacking the next one. So now you can see that it's kind of tiered. And again, we're not gluing that. We're not going to glue that down. It's not necessary. For the third one, we're going to use pieces. We're going to cut them off and we're going to just hot glue around the top until it's almost completely covered. As you can see here, part of my footage did not make it, but you get the idea. You're gluing it down just like that. A little hot glue on the back and putting it down just like that. You don't want to press it flat. We want to give a little, leave a little height in there. Then we're going to press our pick down in there. And you can start using some of these little ornament picks that we made. You can just press them down wherever you like. You can press them under your layers if you want, but I just wanted to add the decorative pieces mainly on the top because it makes it easier to be removed because we are going to be taking these out to change it over to our fall version of this little, I don't know what you want to call this. What would you call this? Because we don't have a candle on it, so we actually couldn't call it that. I'm going to do some in the back, too, to cover it up. If you want to use something to cover up your ribbon back there, you can certainly do that. You can paint the back. You can add another piece of paper on the top of it. But just, you know, for your finished look, you need to do that. But I was just trying to get this project done for you to give you the idea. So there you go. You would want to do something with the bag, obviously. That's not pretty. And this is what our Halloween side would be. All right. And also, I wanted to add, if you're going to use glue, use a little bit of glue on your little decorative pieces that you add. Just a little bit, because you're going to want to remove them. This is what that is going to look like. If you can see it like that. And then, we're going to pull it apart. So here we go. Taking out all the excess, leaving our basic bottom there. So we still have our foam and we still have all of our leaves are still on there. Now we're gonna go and add the fall pick. I'm gonna press that down there, try to make it kind of flat onto the leaves and start adding in some simple greenery. The greenery does not have to be glued. And if you do glue it, you wanna use a tiny bit of glue, not much at all. These are just some scrap pieces that I had left over. You can certainly do something that's a little more symmetrical if you choose. Whatever you like, that's what you want to put in yours. I'm gonna use little orange pieces, and I have a little, just a little random. I think it's a mom. Thank you so much, Teresa, for this wonderful idea.
We're gonna start off with a little bit of ribbon. Whatever type you have is good. Doesn't have to be wired. We're gonna use a glue stick or some adhesive spray. I have a Mod Podge little scraper and a utensil to cut. A block that was thrifted, believe it or not. And I'm just giving you a measurement here so you can get an idea. And this came off the back of a blanket I got at Walmart. It was on the packaging and I liked it, so I cut it out. Now I'm just gonna clean up a little bit on the back. There was some sticker residue, so I wanted to get that off. Wipe it away and get all that off of there. That's nice and clean. And then you can just decide which side you want to go down. You can have your sign so that it will be reversible, or you can cover up the back side, whichever one you like. I'm gonna trace it out on that cardboard paper there and just cut it out. I've decided to use my spray adhesive for this, so you need to cover your surface before you put it on. I've already done that. And then I'm just gonna place down the paper. Once you put it on, it is there. You're not gonna be able to move it. So if you're not sure of yourself, use a glue stick because you have a lot more time there to move things around. I'm just making sure everything is flat and that it is getting a good, nice adhesion there. And then I'm gonna take my sander and go around the edges and just get off whatever is left. I've decided that I like the black and white ribbon as a trim to go around the block. Now, this ribbon is not quite wide enough, but we're gonna fix that. You could always paint your edges first if you would like, but if you didn't do that, then I'm gonna show you a way that you can do it. No problem. We're just gonna go around with that pretty ribbon till we get back to the end and glue it down. Now, if you have paint pens or furniture markers or a fine paintbrush and you feel comfortable with paint, you can certainly use that. But I'm taking my black furniture repair marker and just gonna go around all of the edges on each side of the ribbon on all of the sides so that I have a nice finished look. And then you can barely even tell. Now, this is a part of a tag that I got 100 years ago, both of the stickers as well, from when I was back in my scrapbooking days. I cannot tell you where I got those from, but you can pretty much find these types of tags anywhere. You can get things that are similar at Dollar Tree. And you can use any type of dimensional or flat sticker that you like. You could even hot glue some type of an embellishment if you would like. Just use your imagination here. I happen to like this little cat, so I'm gonna try to center him there and then press him down. You can always use a little hot glue if you want to make sure nothing falls apart, but this is staying here for me pretty nicely. All right, I have a variety of ribbons here. Some were given to me by my neighbor. One came from Dollar Tree. I have a 5-inch embroidery hoop. All of my hoops have come from the thrift store. I've got some of this, these little pumpkins that are plaid, and they came from Dollar Tree. I found them very late in the game. Then a little scrap of fabric here. You're gonna take apart your hoop just like this. Flip your fabric over. The pretty side goes down. Just trying to make sure I don't have any wrinkles there. And I'm gonna press that inner ring down. And it's gonna give us this really pretty polka dot front. I'm gonna take that little screw there and tighten it all up. And then turn your scissors sideways and trim that off. That'll give you a nice clean cut and you won't be able to see it at all from the front. Again, with a furniture marker, I'm gonna go around my edges just like this. This one's really easy and quick to do because it's black on the background, so you don't have to be careful about smearing it or getting it on anything that, you know, might make a mess out of your picture. So there you go. You can go around the edges if you would like with that black marker, if you want to. And I'm just going to take my little pumpkin and put it down and decide if I want an extra embellishment in the middle. You can use stickers or cutouts, whatever you would like. And then with a little hot glue, I'm going to place it toward the bottom. I've decided not to embellish my pumpkin because I want to put a little bow on the top and I don't want it to be just too crazy for a small piece. So I'm going to take some pieces and I'm going to add a little bit of jute in. These are about 5 or 6 inches long. If I had to guess, I did not measure it. But I don't want to use anything that's bigger. because, like I said, it'll be top heavy and it'll lean forward when you hang it up, or when you try to sit it up, it won't be very balanced. Go ahead and finish off your ends any way you would like. If you want a dovetail, you can do that. And then make your stack, just crisscross back and forth, however you want to do it. You don't have to add the jute, or you can add more, or you could add some raffia, whatever you like there. Or you could use your own bow, whatever type you choose. I'm just going to get this tied in the middle, squeeze it tightly, and then I'm going to save my pieces of jute. I'm going to leave them long because we're going to use that to tie it onto that screw area. This is going to cover up that little closure tightening screw. You won't see it, and it'll help our bow stay on the top. Trim it down where it needs to be trimmed. Just look at it and see what needs to go where. You can move things around. And this is how it looks. Now for hanging purposes, you can go ahead and take a piece of string and tie it just like this, or any type of a way that you want to hang that up. You can also, instead of hanging it up, use it on your tiered tray, just like the little cat stand that we did, or the little cat project. It could go on a tiered tray as well. Quite possibly the best, in my opinion, project I have done the entire Halloween series. We're going to start with this pumpkin from Dollar Tree. I'm going to use a little bit of pumpkin orange Waverly chalk paint that came from Plaid. Thank you very much, Plaid. Then I have a little bit of this antiquing wax that I already have. I'm going to put a few drops in here because I want to muddy up this orange paint and give it a more realistic looking dirty pumpkin look. So when I get it the color I like, just like this, I'm going to start brushing it on there. It's just a more natural color, I think, than the one that was already on the pumpkin. And it's going to match the fabric that we're using much better. So two coats of that, let it dry. And then I'm going to take the medium size embroidery hoop and this beautiful cat fabric. I'm going to use this little kitty. There's a bunch of seams on here. It is wrinkled, but you can see in just a moment how to get the wrinkles out. Just like we said before, pull a little bit, press down, pull, then you're going to tighten that screw up. We're going to cut it out. Same process. This is your third one. You are professional at this right now, right? Professional. So you're going to go all the way around it. And you see, it's going to eventually live in the middle of the pumpkin. I'm going to go ahead and use a paint pen for this. I'm using this paint pen or paint marker to go around the edge of this because I have finally had to say goodbye to my black marker. I used all the ink out of my repair marker. And I go all the way around the edges, and you can either go around the edges with that on the sides with that, or you can go use a little bit of paint. And I did use paint, but you won't see that on the camera. It's just a very dark, I think it's called pavement. Now, I'm going to use a wet wipe. Use whatever brand, whatever kind you like. I mean, I think they all pretty much work the same way. I'm just using one I had. And you're going to put a little bit of wax on there, and we're going to make some curves. We're going to add dimension to this pumpkin because I don't want the cartoonish look that we had before. And you can see just by going over the curves, just by fanning it out on the ends and going around the edges, that pumpkin looks so much better. Oh yeah, I did paint that stem, that brown also, I forgot. Okay, so to make a pick on the top, we're gonna spray paint that little stem black. Here's my little finish centerpiece. While our pick is drying, we're going to embellish. A little bit of glue, we're going to put this down. You can glue this any way you want to. You can put it all the way around the rim, or you can just do a couple little dots like I did. Whatever you want to do. Then I have these. They were from way back in the scrapbook days. I'm surprised they still are sticky, but they are. You don't have to use stickers. If you don't have something like this, I chose this because it matches the print. You can see in the print over there behind the pumpkin that it has the kind of viney look. So that's why I chose it. But you can use a pen and freehand this. It's very easy to do this. Or, you know, you could possibly find these stickers. But I'm telling you, I've had them a long time. I love that you can add your own little pieces here to get your own little style. And that was really fun to me. And they're a little bit glittery, so that's nice. And I did go around with my paint pen and bump the edges intentionally to make it look a little more rustic because that there's a like a little rustic look in the background of that cat fabric. So I did do that. Now, after these are nice and dry, be sure they're dry. I'm just going to cut them off the big pick and I'm going to crisscross them over in the middle, just no particular way, just as long as there's equal amount on each side. Another zip tie is how we're going to close it off. Gonna seal these together nicely right in the center. And then clip off the excess here. And I had some of this black left from our witch projects. And I wanna use those definitely on here. We're gonna just crisscross the stems on the bottom. I pulled this off of a piece that came from a different project we did. And then I'm gonna zip tie that together. So, I've got the beautiful colors that coordinate with what's going on in our cat fabric. Love that. And I'm just gonna spread those out a little bit. And I'm gonna take some of the darker leaves that fell off of something else I had. See, I keep everything, which is a good thing and a bad thing. You know how it goes if you craft. Then you're just gonna keep adding until you get it the way you want it to look in the middle. And then again, with a big dollop of glue. I'm going to put this off to the side. I do not want to cover up my stem or anything else. We're going to let it dry completely. Then I'm going to take this little wooden spider. He's from a sticker from Dollar Tree, and I'm going to add him right on the leaves in the top. And then you can use a hanger on the back. You can do this or hang it any way that you like to hang it. You can put jingle blocks on the back and make it a stander if you want to. It'd be a standing sign.
So I'm
Oh,
going to take some jute cord, some scraps of burlap, some scrapbook paper of whatever size, this little Dollar Tree wooden sign, and a thrifted frame. It used to have a picture of a cow on it, but I took the picture off with some fingernail polish remover. Now I'm going to take some of this chalkboard paint. It's black. I'm going to use it to go on the inside of this frame to make it a solid black background. Excuse my voice and my sniffling. If that happens in this video, I do offer my sincerest apologies, but I'm having some allergy issues, and I didn't want to miss the opportunity to get my Halloween videos up because Christmas videos will be coming soon. So I'm just going to edge around here, because I want to keep the outside of that galvanized frame showing. You don't have to, you can use whatever frame you want. If you have a frame that's a large enough frame to sit your trick-or-treat sign down into, you can paint the entire thing black, right over the glass if you choose, or you can spray paint it, however you wish to do it. I just like the idea, since I have a rustic farmhouse theme in my house, of having a little bit of that galvanized still showing through. So I'm just going to do two good coats all the way around here. After I made this video, I subscribe to lots of crafters. So I was watching some of the other people that I subscribe to, and I'd be darned if I didn't pull up a video of another crafter, and she had done a trick-or-treat sign with the exact same coloring as mine. So I just want to say I have no intention of copying anybody. I don't want to take credit for being the only person who's ever done this either. Let's just say that artistic minds think alike. All right, so I've removed the cord from my trick-or-treat wooden sign and placed it down on a piece of paper so that I can begin painting. I'm going to fill in these holes in the top first with some lightweight spackling from Dollar Tree and allow that to dry. This won't be hanging, so I won't need a hanger. It's just going to be glued down inside the frame. Right, so you're going to see a switch in my paint brushes here. I originally started off with this one, and it was still a bit too stiff from the last time I used it. If you don't close your plastic bag all the way up and get as much air as possible out of it, your brush will dry out. So I had to wash it and set it aside. And so I'm going to use this brush, which, by the way, I love. It came in a pack of two, I think, from Dollar Tree. And I'm going to use my Rust-Oleum Linen White chalk paint all over this sign. I'm going in the cracks and the corners so I get a solid white coverage. I did two coats and allowed it to dry. Probably could have gotten away with one coat. You could do this in any color that you want. Since I have a farmhouse rustic theme in my house, I thought that the white would be nice against the black. When it's drying, I am going to make the banner for the top. So I am just making a square and then cutting out triangles to use as a pattern for my fabric and my scrapbook paper. So you're just going to pick out whichever types of paper that you like. I think a variety is a better look, but you can use whatever you want. You could use all of the burlap, or you could use burlap and checkerboard, or whatever you want to use. I've just chosen three different types of papers, and then my burlap, and I'm going to cut out two of each one. The jute cord is going to be the rope that I glue everything onto. This is why it's good to hang on to scraps, because you never know what you might need it for. And this worked out great. This scrapbook paper came from the little pads that come from Target, and I think that every year they have different designs in those little pads. Lay out your pattern the way that you like. And then lay out your twine. Turn each one of those over one at a time and put a bead of hot glue down the edge, and just make sure that it's tapped into place, and that's all you have to do for that. You can space them out. I have just a tiny bit of space between mine, or you can overlap them if you want, or you can leave a bigger space depending on the size of your triangles. Now we're going to put the sign down on the frame, and I'm going to use hot glue and a little bit of Fix-All, which is the Dollar Tree brand super glue. It's kind of a gel in a tube. And make sure I have it centered first, and then pop it into place. It's going to take a little while for that Fix-All to really get a good grip. So I'm just pressing it down so that the hot glue will hold it until that Fix-All does what it needs to do. You're going to see me overlay this with a piece of cardboard and then put down my paint can on top to hold everything in place so it doesn't pop up. Alright, when it's all said and done and that glue has had a good day to dry, you can come in here and put your banner on the top. Now, because I made it big enough where it wouldn't be hanging, I just went ahead and glued it down on there. Just a dot of hot glue and a clamp until the glue has set up, and then I've trimmed off my rope. So it does hang over the edge just a little. I really felt like I needed something else here, so I went back and colored these pumpkins orange. So I used a orange with a dot of brown. This is burnt umber and pumpkin orange. They are acrylic paints. Mix those well together, and then I got a little flat edge brush and applied them carefully to my pumpkins. It's up to you. If you like a brighter orange, go ahead and just use the plain orange. I needed it just a little bit darker. So I'm just carefully going in there and making sure that I'm only getting the top surface. I'm not bothering going around the edges and all that, because it should just be too easy at this point to make a mistake and mess up my black background. So I'm just being sure to go and just tap that and put that on the top. Now I want to put the natural curves of a pumpkin in the bottom, so I'm just making some little curves here. You can make yours flat or whatever you want to do there. One solid curve, whatever. Put on and make a mistake that I can't fix, or I can't easily fix. You can fix anything with paint pretty much, but I don't want to do that. I'd rather be careful and do it right the first time. So now I have my little orange pumpkins with my white words. If you wanted to, you could go in there with a black marker or some black paint and separate your letters and separate the tops of the pumpkins and, you know, that sort of thing if you really wanted it to stand out more. But I like the idea of it looking just, you know, rustic and simple. And it fits in really well with the rest of my black, white, and orange Halloween decor.
All right, so we're going to use some Mod Podge for this project. This is I think this came from Dollar Tree. It doesn't have a sticker on it. And then this scarf that I had used in the other project, this is when I had actually cut it down and then used what I needed on the candle, and then the rest of it was used in the sign. So I got one ahead of the other, but you know, you get the point. You're gonna cut off as much as you need to use here. Leave yourself a little excess. Get your alcohol and your paper towels. Clean this up really well. Then I'm going to take some of that Mod Podge and I'm going to put it in on one little section and decide how I want my base to lay, or my hurricane, or whatever you want to call this. And I'm trying to line the bottom of it up with the edge on the bottom with the trim from the fabric. So you can see down there on the bottom that I'm trying to line it up there. Now this is you're going to have to take some time and be patient and just give yourself some grace, because you're going to have to finagle this around to get those lines and stripes to stay straight, or you will have crooked waves all over the place. It took me some time, and I'll just be honest about that right now. I edited a lot of that out, so you didn't have to see that kind of a struggle, but you can still see what I'm doing here. I'm having to pull it and press it out, add a little bit of glue. Pull it, press it out, add some glue, and when I get it exactly how I want it, I'll go ahead and put that top coat on there. It'll dry pretty hard. The excess is not going to have any glue on it. It'll be trimmed off later, so I'm just going to tuck it in on the top. I'm going to add a little extra glue here on the side where they overlap, and then continue to trim off the excess, because I don't want it to look bulky and, you know, just nasty in the back. I want it to look high-end, like I always say. So here it is, dry, hard as a rock. I'm going to go around and trim the top, leaving just a little bit of a lip. You can use a glue stick, you can use double-sided tape, or you can just fold it under. Whatever type of glue you want to use, you can use. You can even use some more Mod Podge to get that top down if you would like. So now the fun part. I'm going to embellish it with some stickers. These did come from the Target Dollar Spot last year, but I got them at dirt cheap because it's an overstocked store. So they get last year's things this year, and this year's stuff we'll get next year. You know, you get the gist. I'm going to start by putting the center P from Happy in what I think is the center of the vase. And then I'm going to do the same thing with Halloween. And it helps to have the lines because it kind of gives me an idea of, you know, where it should be placed. I'm just pressing those out. And these are kind of felt. They feel like felt. So they're real pliable and easy to use here. Then I'm just going to go down the side too. And press them down in place. And then this is how it's going to look. And we're going to add a candle to it. And I'll show you how that looks. And this is just a little LED. And in the end, you'll see.
Painted black box here, and I have a yard sign that came from Target last year. So I'm not going to use the pick part or the stake part. I'll just put that aside for something else. What we're going to use is the house. And I love how the white trim and the white accents on this house stand out against all of the black. I'm going to use some of this table scatter or vase filler from Dollar Tree. They are black and orange and glittery, and you can get these in different colors. And I'm going to alternate the larger black with the one size down smaller orange, but you can do all the same color, whatever you want to do. You might want to do a dry run first to see what size is going to fit so you don't get to the end and have a big gap. It is just a craft though, you know, these homemade things, they don't always end up like we plan for them to. So sometimes we have happy accidents, but you can always fix things. And if you just use a little bit of glue here, then you could always pull these off and fix it if you need to. I love how the orange and black just kind of remind me of like a carnival booth or something like that. Okay, so since we're going to have this box standing up, in order to get these on here in the right position that it will stand up straight, I've stood the box up like it's going to be when it's completed, and I'm just gluing these down. Now, just a little bit of glue, because you do not want to glue your project to the table. The glue is actually sticking to the ball that's next to it and a little bit on the edge of the box. My box came from Goodwill, but you can get yours anything, maybe at the Dollar Tree. You can get them at Dollar General. You know, you can get these just about anywhere. You can get them at the craft store and paint them yourself. Mine just happened to have already been done, so it was perfect. It made my life a little easier. Okay, so the glue has set up. I'm just removing some of those little webs that come out of there. Look how cute that is. Ugh, I love it. And there's nothing wrong with being proud of your work either. It's gonna be in your house. You want it to be something that brings you joy and makes you happy. So, you know, let it make you happy. Be proud of it. So this is going to be raised, which I love. And thankfully those little spots were on the back where the stake would slide in, and it made a perfect little riser to put some hot glue on to put this down in the box. All right, so now I know I want to have a little sign over here. This came in a 3-pack from Dollar Tree, and they are metal. I like this one, and I want to paint it. So you can get paint at Dollar Tree. It's just an acrylic paint. I have some paint here that came from Hobby Lobby, and I got it on sale 50% off at one time. I think it's pumpkin orange. I'm just gonna take my Dollar Tree brush and I'm just gonna dab this on. You can brush it on if you want to, but I've done it both ways and I always prefer this method of just dabbing it on there or pouncing it on, however you want to name that word. So it's going to cover the entire thing. Just one layer. I don't mind a little bit sticking out because it looks kind of old, so I don't mind that. And then I'm going to set it aside and let it dry. There's my son back talking, carrying on a conversation with me, checking out what's going on. Okay, so now I want to trim this box and I'm going to use this ribbon that I got from Goodwill. You could probably find something like this at Michael's. It's the perfect width to cover the sides of this box. So I'm gonna cut a strip off here and just use a little bit of hot glue to place it down. You know, it's odd the things that seem to make people happy. Well, I think it is for me anyway, because, you know, I had so much, I was so thrilled when my ribbon pattern matched up perfectly once I got it put down. I mean, I was smiling about it and I thought to myself, you know, it's really not that big of a deal, but it is kind of a big of a deal if you can find joy in the small things in life, and something like that made me smile. And hey, you know, that's okay. I'm not hard to please apparently. Matching paper patterns and matching ribbons, and I don't know. Maybe it's just the kid in me that never grew up. And it's on the bottom, so you'll never be able to see it really, but I knew in my head that it matched, and that made me happy. Okay, so now we got our ribbon border down there, and it is looking really good, I think. Yep, it's coming together. And here is my dried sign. I'm just gonna use a little hot glue and put that down, and I've placed the edge of that E in the little gap between those balls there. Be careful, because these do get hot. And I just wanted to mention, I didn't do it because I couldn't find my lights, but you could easily put some string lights around the house or whatever item that you put on the inside, because there is definitely a space between the back of the house and the box. So it would fit there, and then you could have the battery pack on the back and you could light it up, and that would be so cute. So I was playing with my kids there and making it dance around. We like to listen to Halloween music when we craft. But this is it. What do you think? I think it looks cute. I hope you subscribe, because I got more coming and lots more holidays of all sorts coming. Thanks for watching. See you soon. Okay, bye. So I have a thrifted 10-inch wreath. I think you can get something similar to this at Dollar Tree, if not the same thing. And I'm gonna have three different pieces of coordinating fabrics. These are, I think, just cotton fabric. And if you just start with a little snip, you can just tear a straight line all the way up your fabric. So these pieces are somewhere around an inch a piece wide and about 18 to 20 inches long. These are just scraps that I already had from projects last year. And it takes absolutely no special skill to make this wreath. It is easy, but colorful and festive, and the cutest thing for a farmhouse style Halloween. So we're gonna do the same thing with the other two patterns. So I have black with orange polka dots, orange with white polka dots, and then I have another pattern that you will see in just a minute. So I'm just taking these, removing some of the loose threads. I'm gonna put it under
and pull it through the loop. You can just pull on it a little bit and it'll tighten it up around there. No need to use any glue for that. So you'll see later that you can see some of the green foam when I make the wreath. If you want this to be completely not seen at all, you can either paint your wreath form first, or you can put your strips closer together, which would require more strips. And I did not count ahead of time, so yeah, I can't give you those numbers. But you just keep tearing your scraps and until you get enough. And if you don't have enough, then you just keep tearing once you get some of your pieces already on there. Okay, so the other pattern is the orange and white harlequin. And I'm just gonna alternate with black in between the orange and white pieces. When I lay this down on the table and I lay it in half, I am sure to have the non-pretty side up so that when I pull it through, it actually shows on the outside. Did you see the back side of the fabric is what you see, and I put it through and then the pretty side is on the outside. Simple, nothing to it. You're just gonna keep doing this. There's my little witch friend. You're gonna keep doing this until you get it as full as you like. You can let those bands overlap one another, or you can give them a little more space, whichever one you like. Okay, so here is the full wreath, and you can see some green showing through there. That doesn't bother me at all, not one bit. As a matter of fact, once you get to playing around with the strips of fabric enough, you can just about cover the entire thing. See how you just slip them around because they're not glued? You can just move them down, and I think it looks cute. Nothing is perfect. There's some pieces of thread sticking out. Some pieces are longer than others, but that's great. It's rustic, it's country, and it's the style that I like. Okay, so now we want to put some embellishments on it, and I usually cut this part out during editing, but I want you to see my thought process and see what your options could be. The jack-o'-lantern and this bat were both pieces that were broken off of a Target Bullseye Playground stake from last year. And I just sanded the backs down. And so those would be two pieces that could be options to put on here. And I, of course, chose the bat. I think he coordinates nicely. And then this is also one of those things from Target from last year. It's like in a little, maybe metal or enamel sign. This is a little sign that I had forever. It used to have a base on it where you could stand it up. It's a little chalkboard sign. And then from the Dollar Tree, they have these metal signs that you could use. And these can also be painted, so that makes it even better if you want to coordinate your colors. So I'm just getting an idea of what might look cute, what I might like. And finally, I have decided that yes, the spirit lane is the sign that I want on this wreath. So I'm just going to put it down with some hot glue. You could use pipe cleaners if you wanted, or any other way that you want to fix it on there. But this is what works for me today. And I'm pressing and moving my fingers because it's very hot. That metal gets hot, so be very careful about that. You can use your little fingertips if you want to. And then this little bag of scatter came from Dollar Tree. Just little glittery spheres of different shapes, well, different sizes. And there's some little bitty black ones. And I'm gonna use those to cover up the holes on the ends of these signs. It's almost like a little street sign. But they're barely noticeable once you get the wreath hanging up. But there it is, cute as can be. If you're new, I hope you subscribe and come back and see more content. You'll be notified if you do subscribe and hit the little bell. Give me a like if you're enjoying these Halloween videos. Thanks for stopping by, and we'll see you again real soon. Bye.